Yes, we should do space exploration. Here's why. While the first human didn't leave our planet for the vast reaches of space until 1961, people have been staring up into the night sky in wonder since time began. Ancient civilizations tracked the stars and named the planets after their gods. Much later, after the moon landing in 1969, the world buzzed with excitement at the prospect of our species being a space-faring civilization. Of course, the decades that followed the moon landing weren't quite as exciting. Projects got slashed, and very few astronauts left our watery planet. So for many people, the idea of being a space-faring race anytime soon started to feel like a distant dream. That is, until now. With exciting projects like SpaceX's Mars mission, NASA's Artemis project that will return humans to the moon, and the imminent launch of the James Webb Telescope, the hunger for space exploration is back. However, expensive projects always attract debate. You've probably heard people saying space exploration is a waste of money or shouldn't be a priority, but we disagree. Without further delay, here are the reasons why space exploration is so important. New technologies are born. In a section called Why We Explore, NASA says humans are driven to explore the unknown, discover new worlds, push the boundaries of our scientific and technical limits, and then push further. The intangible desire to explore and challenge the boundaries of what we know and where we have been has provided benefits to our society for centuries. This statement touches on a critical point. The reason why we want to explore space might be driven first and foremost by a desire to satisfy our curiosity and conquer the unknown. But through this pursuit, amazing things are achieved. Without space exploration, we wouldn't have much of the technology we rely on today. Here are just a few examples of technology born from space programs. GPS. Whether it's to navigate an unfamiliar location or to track a parcel, you've probably used the Global Positioning System, GPS. But did you know that GPS has its origins in the Sputnik era of space exploration? Scientists used GPS to track the satellite, and the rest is history. Firefighting equipment. In an effort to create insulating and protective astronaut clothing, NASA has spent a lot of time and money researching flame-retardant polymers. Today, these polymers are used in firefighter suits. Insulin pumps. The technology we now use to regulate blood sugars and release insulin for people with diabetes was first invented to monitor astronauts' vital signs in space. Other notable inventions include solar cells, water filtration, wireless headsets, CAT scans, invisible braces, memory foam, the computer mouse, smartphone cameras, scratch-resistant glass, and much more. You've probably heard that they also invented Velcro and Teflon, but this is actually a myth. While NASA did put these materials to good use in their space missions, Teflon has been around since 1938, and Velcro the 1940s. However, it's fair to say that NASA popularized these materials, leading to their widespread use today. Dwindling resources. Earth has a finite amount of resources, and this limits our potential for technological expansion. You might think we could create more highly sought-after elements in a lab, but this isn't always feasible. For example, you can't make gold using chemical reactions from something that doesn't already contain gold. However, we can find tons of gold on asteroids, along with other precious metals like platinum and various rare earth metals. Asteroid mining would give us access to unthinkable levels of resources and vast wealth. How much? The asteroid belt alone contains many thousands of times the Earth's entire GDP. So why not mine on those asteroids instead of our home planet? The ultimate backup plan. If there's one thing we know for sure, it's that humanity can't live on Earth forever. Even if we set aside the possibility that we will cause our own demise through climate change or a nuclear war, the Earth still has an expiry date. 600 million years from now, solar radiation levels will reach a tipping point, and trees will no longer be able to photosynthesize. And in 4 billion years, all life on Earth will be extinct due to the extreme temperatures. By exploring space now, we can learn how to reach other planets and set up self-sustaining colonies. It's better to start looking for a new home before you're being pushed out the door. Sometimes you need to leave home to understand it. Studying other planets can help us solve some scientific mysteries here on Earth. For example, scientists studying Mars discovered that the red planet had ripples in its sand dunes, which we don't see on Earth. This discovery changed the way scientists think about the physics of sedimentary processes on Earth. So, that's it for today! What part of space exploration are you most excited about? Let us know in the comments! If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. And if you didn't, just like the video anyways. Really, it's like 2 seconds. Thanks a ton, and we hope to see you when it's time again for What's Next?